Okay, the federal payroll is going to grow to 2.15 million. That's how many people are going to be working for the federal government. Oh, yeah, and about a million jobs just magically disappeared. Hello, it's February 4th, 2010. I'm Reginald, also known as DemCad. First, college tuition increases. We're looking at double-digit increases across the country. In Florida, students could be facing a 15% increase. A 15% increase. University of Illinois students are looking at least 9% increase. University of Washington is going to charge about 14% more. 14% more. These are huge increases. In California, they're talking about 30% increases. This is crazy. This is really crazy here. And let me tell you something. As far as I'm concerned, there's not a lot of evidence that supports the idea that going to college is going to lead to a much better job. At least in terms of a job that pays you enough to justify all the debt you're going to get into going to college. Man, anyway, Phoenix is basically losing its mind. Their city council approved a 2% food tax on... A food tax. 2% tax on food. And now there's some group that's actually advocating a 4% tax. Ann Malone, who runs the Indian School Corridor Citywide Coalition, is basically, well, she said, quote, "Would you rather pay $4 extra, so $104 instead of $100 for your groceries, or would you rather keep the $4 and lose your after-school programs, lose the recreation center, and have your bus fare increase? I'd rather save money on the food." I mean, first of all, food is something you absolutely need. You don't necessarily need after-school programs. I mean, to be frank, it's nice to have some, but you don't really need that. And as far as a recreation center, well, it's called a recreation center. So why don't you start charging fees for people if they want to participate in recreation? You know? And a bus fee, I mean, shoot, my big butt a walk. I mean, I do walk, so you know, I mean, $4 is actually a lot. 4% is actually a lot when you go to the grocery store. I mean, who taxes food? I mean, this is crazy. Anyway, there's been a breakthrough in HIV/AIDS research. Basically, some U.S. and British scientists have discovered some important things about the structure of enzymes. And basically, they're moving closer and closer to developing specialized drugs that can really target HIV more effectively. So if you want to read about that, click on the link. Top uniform officer wants to lift the ban on gays in the military. Basically, Admiral Mike Mullen, who is the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, is saying that the military can pretty much handle this. He strongly supports allowing gays to serve openly in the military, and I agree 100%. You know, I think if you're going to have these people risk their lives, you know, they have every right to be who they are, you know? Why should they live in secrecy? As long as they do their job, it's nothing to get angry about. I just think it's fair. Ex-POW, well, basically, you all heard about Jessica Lynch and how there was an ambush and she was kidnapped. Well, what you didn't hear about is this other lady, this black lady named Shalanda Johnson. She was shot in both her legs. She was held captive for 22 days. And this article sort of highlights her struggle. She's a 37-year-old single mom. She has mental health issues because of her whole ordeal. And I figure I'll mention this because I think it's funny how the media only focuses on certain types of people. For example, Jessica Lynch was pretty much focused on, in my opinion, because she was white, she was cute, and she was a female. Now, if she was a guy, they probably wouldn't have cared. If she was a white female and she wasn't attractive, they probably wouldn't have cared, you know? So, I mean, it's a great deal of sexism, and you guys just say it's sexism, racism, and I don't know how you define the whole discrimination against just normal people. But anyway, I just think with the media, it's not so much as racism and sexism. I just think the media looks for, they look to turn everything into entertainment in a sort of weird way. They want to sensationalize everything. But anyway, she's the first black female POW, the first official one. And I figure since I'm talking about black history this month, well, I sound like some corporation with this black history stuff, but It's really American history. But anyway, just thought I'd mention that. Largest ever federal payroll hits 2.15 million. That's a big government. That's a lot of people working for the federal government. A lot of people. And most of the growth is pretty much coming from the civilian side. They added about 153,000 workers. Holy smokes. That's a lot of people. That's a big government. And boy, you know, when I was talking about jobs all this time, and you guys were talking about, well, some of you guys were saying things are getting better and this and that, I was trying to explain to you guys the whole birth-death model. Well, as of February 5th, 824,000 jobs will disappear. Basically, the government's been using this bogus birth-death model, and now they're finally admitting that even though these jobs didn't appear in the monthly numbers, these jobs that are lost really exist. So they're going to have a revised report, and you can read about it right in the description box. Told you this is what they do. I mean, when are you guys going to... A lot of you guys get it, but some of you guys are just listening. You just don't get it. Anyway, Movie Gallery files for bankruptcy. I don't know if that's really related to the economy, but they're trying to shut down 805 stores. I don't know if it's really related to the bad economy or the fact that it's very difficult to compete with Netflix, which, in my opinion, is a much better way of getting movies, and Redbox as well. Not that I'm endorsing anybody. I'm just saying. Anyway, I'm still working on my radio show. If you have any ideas for what you want me to talk about on my radio show, please send me a personal message. Do not email me because I spend more time on YouTube than at my email. Alright guys, thank you for supporting this channel. Thank you for watching this video. Please rate it. It definitely helps the video. And hey, comment. Have a good day. Bye.